Hello, everybody. The wife is having a new pen built, so I decided to film it. I don't know if I showed you some of her recent acquisitions. Just ignore me. I'm doing my YouTube stuff. I won't make you an international YouTube star if you don't want to be one. Heritage Rhode Island Reds. Nobody has a name yet, but here they are in their pen. And you saw the wood. Got all the wood here, and we're over here, and we're building more pens for more birds. My wife doesn't like the beautiful pens I built over there, so she's getting these people here to build this pen because she thinks they can build it better, you know, like square and measured and all that stuff. I'm an inch person, not an inch and a quarter. I don't deal that way. I pretty much figure if it's within an inch, it's probably good enough, right? But I'll be showing you some stuff, pieces, a little bit. See you in a minute. And mark. Oh, I was about to make a comment about how hard it was to see the screen out in this bright light, but yeah, that was because I had the lens cover closed. Here is what we're doing so far. Yeah, they look crookedy because we are still getting the distance between the poles right. We're gonna have to do that, and then we are we're going out to here, right here, down this line, and this corner looks kind of junkety. It's where we had the old wood pile. I finally managed to burn all that stuff up. We just got to clear out the rest of the bark and some newspapers that got blown over here from they were supposed to be in the burn pile from coupons and stuff, but the big wind blew them over here before they got burnt, and now they made this mess. So we're gonna clear this area out here. This is gonna be a large square. There's gonna be pins going down there. There are ways similar to these, and this large square area in here where this will all be a large area, and there'll be a little angled door right here. They'll go in, and this will be storage. All the little brooder areas for the little babies will be in here. Little brooder pens and brooder cages stacked up. And cleaning and food will all be in this area. And just the door's got to be wide enough for a wheelbarrow. Hey, girls. Hey, boys. But that's this plan so far. And normal large pile of junk that I'm got to get rid of over there behind that. But here's what we're using. Just some screws, some cobalt tools and stuff. Have some stuff from Harbor Freight. Some tools. Harbor Freight's hit or miss for me. Some of the stuff is good. This auger's doing okay, except it still spins even when it's not supposed to. As soon as you start it, it starts to spin a little bit. It's not supposed to do that. So that's an issue, but we've used it for quite a while. You can see it's kind of dusty and dirty. All these post holes that we've dug around here have come from that auger. And where we are, that's a big benefit. I don't know, let me see if I can... A little bit left here that hasn't been trampled. The red right there, there's clay under most of our yard. And man, some parts of our yard, the clay is really close to the surface, and if it's like the summer when we're doing a lot of these projects, it seems that clay is like concrete. We have to wait till it rains. So it rained this weekend, and we have some soft ground, and that's why we're doing the project now. I will bring you guys along on the steps further. All right, talk to you in a bit. And Mark, hey, how are you guys? This is the project getting screwed together, but unfortunately the rain has come, and so gonna be put on hold for a little bit. Here's everybody out, new men over here. They're all under the tarp. I don't know what she's doing or he's doing out there. He's braving the rain, I guess. When you see the little ones over there, let me see if I can zoom in. Yeah, they're running back and forth. There they go. There they go. They're running back and forth. They need to get under the house. I don't know what they're doing. And then over here, woo, zoom out. They're all under the table. They've locked him out. They're like, we're under here. This is quarantine pen. It does have a thing on it. It's an old, what you call it? A trampoline thing, netting. And so it doesn't completely block the rain. It kind of spreads it out and makes it almost like a mist over him. And so with their feathers, you can see it's just rolling off his back. I don't know if you can see that zoomed in or not. It's just rolling off his back, beating up, rolling off. He's fine, they're good. But this is what all this is, pins for all these guys and stuff. Getting more pins. But they're in quarantine anyway over here for a little bit longer because they're new, and you know, when we introduce new chickens, we don't want to introduce new diseases or sicknesses and have our flock get killed off or something. Because it has happened, it can happen, and it will happen if you're not careful. All right, well, rain seems to have let up a little bit at least. It's probably just going to be a light drizzle. I've got to zoom out, actually. Got to get all these tools and stuff all up into the garage safe and sound because the tent here that we have has leaks. Little leaks, tiny leaks. It's an old tent. I would say, how many? 5 years, I think, we had this one. And so it's good for keeping the sun off of you, but not so good for keeping the wet off of you. I mean, I'm not going to get soaked in here, but, you know, a little droplet here and there, and it beads up on the underside of it and starts rolling off. Oh, man, I don't know if I get this up before the other stuff, but I am working on editing the battle report videos that I have, getting those up online, and making a few for some other games. I pulled my back out this weekend. My back is still out at this point. But I have some medicine from the VA, pain medicine that I've taken, and just using it to stay functional to get this stuff done. It's gotta get done because chickens need homes and there's no one else to do it. Have a little bit of money, hire some people to help us, which is what we've done. But we don't have a whole lot of money, and that's going to run out here soon. And then we'll be on our own again and doing what we can. All right, that's my wife calling, so I'll talk to you later. And Mark. Hey there, guys, gals, chicken people, and whoever not. Here is the progress so far on the pins. You see, it's almost, we got to cut the little tops off there. And because the ground is uneven, so these are not evenly in the ground. But this is progress so far in the chicken pens. I know it looks more like a building. It kind of is. This opening for door. And then this door will be right beside this door. And yeah, this first frame wasn't quite square. Not really our fault. The people who are helping us didn't make it square. And so... now we're alone, and wow, she left all the staples out here. That's okay. I'll get those in a little bit. But now we are stapling. Fortunately, I have this air gun, air compressory thing. It's not the most strongest one, but it was what we could afford at Lowe's, and it does well for the minor projects that we have. It's small brad nails, the staples, and all that stuff. And as you can see, just open the door here. Just stapled on the inside, little staples, nice and tight for the chickens. Using the smaller wire because for the babies, we'll fill in these ditches. We dug and we're leveling, and in this back we're going to place, can't describe it other than a metal wall, because as you can see the slope here, and over here how things are sloped. This area here kind of is sloped this direction, and then over there by that fence it comes down and goes to the gutters in the road, and so not flood the house. So to prevent this chicken pen area from being flooded, what we are going to do is take some metal and line this whole back area and then dig a little trench out there and fill it with stones and such not, and basically angle it down and create an area to keep the water going the direction it's supposed to be, but not flood out the chicken pens. I'm going to be roof up here. It's a crossbar for it. I'm going to have little bars up there to raise it just slightly. Still have to have the two crossbars there, but other than that, and those two doors, these three are done. And this is all we had the money kitted out for us, these three. And these are going to be big enough for what we're putting in here. We're going to have a roost area and nesting boxes and all that back here will eventually get built. But because this little flock like here is going to be the standard for us. One or two roosters, three hens or so, 3 to 4 hens. So plenty of space for them, and then they'll get to go out and roam the yard and play around. When Trevor Trav, who doesn't eat chickens but likes to run around and chase chickens, was up in the house, and during the summer, as you can see right now, he's going crazy. But he is, there you go, chase chickens. But he is slobberating. He likes being outside. He loves being outside. But during the summer, he's got to be inside most of the time, or else he just overheats like crazy. It's crazy time for poor German Shepherd, the cold climate dog down here in the south. But yeah, this is what we got. And I just wanted to show you guys progress so far. And as we move on, I'll show you more. I'm sorry about some of the other videos. I've reviewed them. I haven't put them together, but I noticed that the other parts are probably what will be this whole video. And some are foggy, and some are like I'm pointing at things that you're not interested in while I'm talking. But hey, it's all good. All right, guys, I have to take a picture for purposes on my wife's cell phone. And then we'll see you later then. All right, talk to you later.